Hello friends, I am Om Arora of Class 6 studying in Father Agnew School. In my previous video, I showed a demo of my obstacle avoiding car. Today, I am going to show you how to make that amazing car. The materials you will be needing are 1 robot chassis, 2 DCBO motors, 2 wheels to fix on the motors, 2 IR sensors, 1 caster wheel, 1 push switch, some screws, and 1 L293D IC, some 9 volt batteries, 1 battery connector, a pair of scissors, some tape, a breadboard, some wires, and a motor clamp. So let's start making this car. First, we have to connect the caster wheel to the chassis. I am connecting it with the help of screws. You can connect it with anything you want. As you can see, I have connected it. You just have to screw them tightly. Now we will connect the motors. As you can see, I have already connected one motor. I will show you how to connect the other motor. Take the motor and the motor clamp. Now fix it with the help of screws like this. Make sure that you fix all the screws tightly as so as they can stay immobilized. Now we will use another screw. As you can see, these are firmly connected and cannot move. Now we have to connect the motor to the chassis. These screws should also be very tight so that the motors will stay immobilized. As you can see, I have connected it to the chassis. Now we will fix the wheels on. Now your robot should be able to stand. Don't worry if it's going over to the back. Now we will fix the breadboard onto the chassis. The breadboard comes with an inbuilt DST. You just remove the cover and stick it. Now we will start making the connections. First, take the IC, L293D, and fix it to the breadboard like this. Then use the battery connector, fix the positive wire and the negative wire. Then connect this positive from here to the positive over here, and then the negative from here to here. Don't worry, we'll fix it later. Now we'll start making the connections. The first pin of this IC will have positive current. Positive. The second pin of this IC will have the output of the IR sensor. As you can see, there are three pins in the IR sensor. The middle pin is the positive pin. The black wire is the negative pin, and this red wire is the output pin. We will fix this red wire, which I have used the blue wire, to the second pin of this IC. The third pin of the IC is the output of the motor. We will fix the negative of the motor to this pin. This is a negative, so we will fix the negative over here. The next two pins of this IC are negative, so we will use wires to connect these two pins to the negative of the battery. And negative. Another wire. This also negative. Now we have another output for motor. We will connect the positive of the motor to this pin. Then we will connect this second last pin of this IC to the positive of the motor, to the positive of the battery. Then the last pin will be connected to the positive of the battery. Now the IR sensor's positive will be connected to the positive of the battery and the negative to the negative of the battery. I'm sorry, the pin isn't going in. It's gone. So the positive of the sensor will be the positive of the battery, and the negative of the sensor will be the negative of the battery. Similarly, do the same for the other side. As you can see, I have similarly joined the other motor. For more clarification, please refer to the circuit diagram. Now we will start attaching the batteries. You can use some double-sided tape to attach the battery to the chassis. And make sure that if your robot is going backwards, make sure you connect it to the front part of the robot so that it stays balanced. Yes. So the positive wire will go to the positive terminal where all the positive terminals are connected, and the negative wire to where all the negative terminals are connected. Like this. So first we will connect the IR sensors in such a way that they can detect the valve and stop accordingly. The sensors should be placed such as when a valve should be sensed at this point, this motor should stop working so that this can move and rotate like this. Similarly, on the other side, when this side detects a wall like this, this motor should stop working so it can move on like this and this and this. So we can use some tape and some double-sided tape to place these sensors. Just make sure that the sensors which you are placing at this side or of this motor. As you can see, the output of this sensor is going for this band, this motor. So I am placing it correctly. You can also use some tape. Now, as you can see, I have connected the IR sensors with some tape. You can connect them with anything you want, but you have to make sure of one thing, that whatever you use to cover to make sure that they are fixed to the chassis, the things which you are using to stabilize them should not come in front of the IR receiver and sending pair. So I will give you a demo of this project once again. The positive will go to the positive terminal, the negative to the negative. As you can see, when I place my hand in front of this sensor, this motor stops working. When I place my hand in front of this sensor, this motor stops working. Similarly, a turn turns. Turn turns. And now I should give you some tips. If your motor is rotating in the opposite direction, I suggest that you interchange the positive and the negative of the motor. And instead of removing your battery, removing the wires every time you want it to be on and off, I suggest you can use a switch as this. You fix it on the breadboard. Your negative wire should be where it should be, and the positive should be the first pin over here, and you use one more wire, which will be the second pin in here, and it should go to the place of the positive wire, which is over here. So when this button is on, the car will start moving, but when it is off, it will be off. See, it's on and then it's off. Thank you.